Well, hello everyone. Welcome back. It's been about a year, I think, since our last get together where you learned to play the spoons. Well, I'm just going to take just a minute or so to review some of the things we learned. And one of the things I showed you is to use regular tablespoons at home to make spoons for playing. And personally, I don't like using them because after playing for a while, I get blisters on my finger. So, but I'll show you how to use the spoons. What you need to do is to set the wide part of the bottom of the spoon in your palm like this. Make sure the spoons are facing away from each other. Put your pointer finger in between the two spoons and put the other part inside your palm, and put a little distance away from the back of the spoon. So it may be about maybe a quarter inch to a half inch away from the back, that you can use your pointer finger to make that space. And that is how to make spoons, tablespoons to play with. But they also make these spoons with plastic handles already built in. You can order them on Amazon. And I would suggest that if you're going to use regular spoons for playing, that you would get those, because those will be easier on your finger. So that's what I taught you last time. I also showed you some different wooden spoons that you can purchase. Some have a cup that's on the outside, so that when you play them, if you block the cup, it sounds like a clapping sound. This one has the cups on the inside, so if you look on the inside, the little cup is facing each other. This is the spoon that I'm going to play today. So you have some with a cup on the outside, some with the cup on the inside. If you buy wooden spoons, make sure you buy one that has a little lip on the outside, because it is a useful little thing, and I'll show you about that later. See, this one also has that little extension. And these you can buy on Amazon also. All right. The last time that we had a class on the spoons, I started out by saying just keep a beat. You know, when music is playing, your foot kind of taps on the floor just to keep the beat with the music. Sometimes you might just bob your head and so forth. Well, you do the same with the spoon. You just kind of keep a beat with the spoon. That would be the simplest beat to play on a spoon. Now, if you double that beat, and then you add your hand on top, you can use your hand as a place for your spoons to hit. So your beat is actually not only doubled, but it's I don't know what you call it. It's doubled twice. Well, what we're going to do today is we're going to start with that simple beat. We're going to find a fiddle tune that we are going to play with, and that's all we're going to do. No moving of hands, just the simple. We can pause every once in a while like this. So let's find a fiddle tune and let's play the first fiddle tune with that simple beat. Okay? All right. I have found my fiddle tune that we're going to work with. Now here's what we're going to do. We're going to let the fiddler play the first loop and then we're going to start. So if you just watch me, generally that's what you do. You don't start playing the spoons immediately when the fiddler starts. You let him start and then after the first round, you can kick in. Okay? So that's what we're going to do. And all we're going to do is this. You can just do that. All right? So here we go. I pause the music because we're going to change the technique. I've seen people who play, who sing standing up, so they do not have a knee to bang on. So what they do is they use their fingers. They make a large C with their finger. And then they actually... So that's the technique we're going to use right now, okay? So it's the same thing as your knee, except you're going to be using, and in this case, we can include something else like this. So with the next part of the medley that's playing right now, we're going to use this technique for that part of the medley. And then I'll pause again and we'll use another technique. And then why don't we put it all together? All right? So I will just back up a little bit. Ready? Thank you. find another tune and add another technique.
Here you go. This is a tune I learned from.
The next fiddler is a fiddler that is a Métis fiddler. Métis are Indian group that developed an a fiddling style, and she does like 365 days, 365 different fiddle tunes in 365 days. One of the tunes is Rubber Dolly. Rubber Dolly is kind of like kind of a popular fiddle tune, especially in this area. So that's what we're going to do right now, and the technique we're going to do this time is something that we learned last time, which is instead of using just the palm of your hand to play, you rotate your hand around. It just adds a little. It doesn't make any difference. It just adds a little frosting. If somebody is looking at you play, at least you're not always having the palm down, and it gets kind of like boring to look at after a while. So if you can add a little flavor to your playing, it excites the people a little bit. So rotating your arm, like your hand, like this. Yeah, it just adds a little something. Okay, so that's what we're going to do this time with Rubber Dolly. So here's Rubber Dolly. We're going to let her do the loop again, then we'll start. Increasing the speed kind of makes me miss the beat. Now we're going to choose another song and another fiddle tune, and we're going to add those elements to our playing. We're going to just do what we had done before. Rotate our hand. Make our C cup. Every once in a while, if you want to add a rake in there, you can rake. You get it? You can also do it here. Now, this is hard to do, so if you mess up, don't worry, because I mess up too. I don't always get it right. And so I'm going to find another fiddle tune right now, and we're going to play along with that one. All right, the fiddle tune that I've chosen to do with the spoons is Ragtime Annie. Ragtime Annie is also a very popular fiddle tune around here. You'll recognize it just as soon as Patty starts to play it. So here we go. Remember, let her go through the first round, then we'll start the spoons.
Here we go.
Fiddle is an American fiddle tune, and we're going to do that next. Thank you. Okay, let's change the style of music. Let's go to maybe a country tune instead. You don't have to do the spoons only to the fiddle music. You can do it to any kind of song you want. So we're going to change the genre of music. We're going to go to a country tune. So let me find a country song for you that we can do the spoons to. All right, this is a country classic song. It's Crazy by Patsy Cline. It's slow for a spoon, but just to show you that you can play spoons with a slower country songs or waltzes and so forth. It's not as exciting for the player, but you know, it'll still be you'll still be acting as a kind of a beat behind the scene. All right, so here we go.
Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely.
Kind of easy to play.
I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. Love me as long as you want it, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let my
stop this song and go to something a little faster in country music. Okay? The next song we're going to do is one that's a classic number everybody knows. It's Jambalaya by Hank Williams. It's a little bit more upbeat on country music, and so it'll probably be a little more fun to play on your spoons. So here we go. We'll wait till
goodbye, Joe. Me gotta go, me oh my. Me gotta go.
We'll start playing the spoons on the chorus.
My Yvonne, the sweetest one, me oh my. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou.
Okay, ready?
Jambalaya, coffee, pie. Cause tonight I'm gonna see my academy. Tickets up, fill for sure, and jail. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bio. Style, go home. heart filled with dark and yellow. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bio.
With country music. All right, next we're going to do some jazz, and I did say we'd do country, so I decided to combine the two together. One of my favorite albums of Willie Nelson is his jazz album, Twilight, I think it's called, and I'm going to choose a couple numbers from that album, and it's got kind of a nice slow beat, and it's got the jazz part to it too, so let's give that a try. The first song we're going to do, I think, is called The Sunny Side of the Street, which some of us will remember. Yeah, actually, senior college, you should all remember. So here we go.
Grab your coat, get your hat, leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Can't you hear a pitter-pat? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to in the shade with those blues on the grave, but I'm not afraid. This rover crossed over. If I ever had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street. This rover crossed over. If I ever had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on sunny side.
Another one by Willie Nelson, it's All of Me, and it comes from that same album, that country jazz album.
All of me, why not take for me. Can't you see I'm no good without you? Take my arms, I'm losing. Take my lips, I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes to cry. And I know that I am no good without you. You took the part that once was my heart. So why not take all of me?
Familiar with the classic In the Mood by Glenn Miller, and that's where we're going to play the spoons to now. So here we go. Ready? Thank you. we got the idea. All right, we're going to do a medley of fiddle tunes now. You'll see the spoons are just more exciting to play with fiddle tunes. And so we're going to end with this medley. The medley, let me check. There's Maple Sugar Reel. Everybody is familiar with that. It's a common one here. Big John McNeil's is not as common, but it's a nice fiddle tune. And then St. Anne's Reel, which everybody knows. All right, so let's get started. So here we go. We could use the spoons with, and if there's interest, we could do it again sometimes. So thank you for joining us. Have a good time with your spoons.